And as I said, we'll go to Hassan first on the line from South. Speak to us, Hassan.
Hi, Duncan.
Welcome.
I have mentioned this before, that being a British Conservative, I would obviously support the Republicans in America.
But when you say obviously, that's not necessarily assumed, because some British Conservatives would be Democrats in America.
You're right, you're absolutely right. I mean, when you had General Colin Powell and John Kasich, Mitt Romney move over to the Democrats, even George W. Bush, you're absolutely right. There are Republicans who are going to vote Democrat and support Biden. So, yeah. But I would support the Republicans minus Donald Trump. I mean, he has done no favours for the Republicans, I believe. And one thing I'm noticing in American politics is that the conversation has become so toxic, it is unbelievable. The amount of vitriol on both sides, and, you know, that does not help democracy. I myself, a little Hassan from Slough, try to engage with socialists in America, and it can actually happen. I have engaged with socialists from very far on the left, and the Republicans, I think, they need to stop attacking Kamala Harris's racial heritage. It doesn't matter whether she's African American or Indian Jamaican, she's an American. And attacking Joe Biden's cognitive decline. I mean, the only one possible positive thing that Trump could promote, if it is true, I've yet to verify it, is when he said in response to President Bush's criticism of Trump, that under his presidency, the incarceration of black men have actually decreased than ever before. On the jobs amongst African Americans have increased.
I know on the economy, I know that he's the facts are that are out there. I haven't looked at the prison side of things, but when he talks about falling unemployment among African Americans, the president is in line with how the facts demonstrate that.
Yeah, so that is what should be promoted. The policy, there's no need for personality attacks. I mean, under Kamala Harris and Joe Biden, I think the incarceration rates have actually gone up, especially when Kamala was the Attorney General. And finally, this is a question I posed to the Democrats, I've had no answer, and the socialists whom I did engage with, she didn't really give an answer, and it is about the Me Too movement and sexual harassment. But remember, 2 years ago, there was a lot of attacks on Brett Kavanaugh by Democrat senators, but it's Elizabeth Warren, Cory Booker, Kamala Harris, and so on. They had the right to put him in the spot, and you might remember Kamala Harris actually really put Brett Kavanaugh on the spot when he couldn't answer her question. But for some reason, they are this complete collective silence on the issue of Biden and Tara Reid. And I cannot understand why, because what is so important about Trump that they are afraid to call out Biden on sexual harassment? Now, the response from the socialist was that because she also has called out Biden on the sexual harassment, it's probably people are more afraid of what Trump could do. So my question is, what could Trump do that is so bad that they have to remain collectively silent on sexual harassment, which is a very, very important issue?
All right, Hassan, thank you very much for calling in, and pleasure to hear from you. Let's go to